Hey everyone, I miss you guys. I'm nearly done with my move, so you don't have to wait much longer for more scary stories. I won't have decent internet again until the 15th. Until then, I'll use my phone's hotspot and try to get you guys some appetizer stories, like this one. Today, I've got an allegedly true tale about a ghost train. Don't laugh just yet, because you may end up a passenger aboard this phantom engine. This story was submitted by Ghost Train 87. Enjoy. In the Blue Ridge Mountains of western North Carolina, the Boston Bridge train wreck occurred on August 27, 1891, just west of Statesville. The accident took the lives of 24 people, making it one of the worst railroad disasters in North Carolina history. Richmond and Danville, R&D, engine number 9, left Statesville at approximately 2:30 a.m., bound for the resort mountain town of Asheville, pulling 6 passenger cars, a baggage car, a second-class car, 2 first-class coaches, a Pullman sleeper, and the private passenger car of the Richmond and Danville superintendent. According to the station agents, engineer William West was 34 minutes late and left Statesville in a hurry, obviously intending to make up lost time. Less than 5 minutes after leaving Statesville, the train plunged off Boston Bridge, a 70 feet high, 5-span brick tower bridge crossing Third Creek. Because of its speed, which would later be estimated at 40 to 45 miles per hour, by the coroner's jury. The train was literally airborne when it derailed. The sleeping car hit the ground 157 feet from where it left the bridge. Several battered survivors walked back to Statesville to announce the disaster, and all normal activity ceased that day as the town immersed itself in the rescue effort. The injured were transported to Statesville, which had no hospital, and placed in private homes. As for the dead, they were taken to a tobacco warehouse to be later identified. Once the rescue effort ended, the wreck site became a magnet for the curious. Thousands of people arrived to stare off the bridge at the wreck or to prowl among the debris looking for valuables of the passengers. Photographers William Stimson of Statesville and a Mr. Van Ness of Charlotte took pictures, and according to the Statesville paper, The Landmark, they sold hundreds of photos in the coming weeks. A news story of the wreck soon featured a Van Ness photograph, specifically Frank Leslie's Weekly Illustrated newspaper. The Police Gazette of Boston carried a story illustrated with what The Landmark called one of its loud, imaginary pictures. 4 days after the incident, a coroner's inquest concluded that it was caused by unknown persons removing spikes from the rails, though some blamed the track's neglected condition. Inasmuch as the Richmond and Danville was experiencing financial troubles, officials fearing huge damage suits worked feverishly to find the alleged train wreckers. For months, railroad detectives swarmed over the area. Several people were detained and questioned, but eventually released. Later that year, 2 men already in the state penitentiary in Raleigh were convicted of causing the tragedy on the strength of their supposed confessions to other inmates. 50 years later, very early in the morning of August 27, 1941, a woman was waiting along the road that ran beside the railroad tracks near Statesville. Her husband had gone to get help after their car had a flat tire. The woman heard a train whistle in the distance. A headlight appeared down the track, sweeping through the trees as the engine approached. The woman noticed the huge bridge in front of the train. As the engine began to cross it, she heard a horrible crash. She saw the train plunge off the bridge, its old-fashioned wooden passenger cars splintering into pieces. They piled into a jagged mound below. The woman could hear the screams and groans of the wounded people. She ran across the road, through a field to the side of the creek. Up close, the sight was even more horrendous. The steam locomotive, Its tender, the car attached to the engine carrying its water and coal, and passenger cars, formed a mangled mess of wreckage being flooded by the waters of Third Creek. Hearing a car pull up on the road behind her, the woman ran back across the field, screaming that a terrible train wreck had happened. Her husband was in the car with a stranger, the man who owned the country store just down the road. The three of them headed back across the field and looked down into the quiet waters of Third Creek. The wreck was no longer there. Of course, the men thought that the woman had fallen asleep and dreamt the whole thing up. But when they continued their trip, she made her husband stop by the Statesville train station to find out if there had been a wreck there. When the couple asked at the ticket window, the station agent looked up from his work. "Funny you should ask," he said. "There was no wreck on the railroad last night. But 50 years ago today, there was a horrible wreck out there at Bostian's Bridge." As he said this, the woman screamed and fainted. She knew she had seen a ghost train. On August 27th, 2010, a group of 12 individuals who considered themselves amateur ghost hunters gathered at Bostian's Bridge, hoping to catch a glimpse of the ghost train. Unfortunately for them, a real train came down the tracks at about 2:45 a.m., the same time they anticipated a sighting of the ghost train. The group did not immediately run from it, initially believing it was, in fact, a phantom train. Christopher Kaiser, 29, who had ventured onto the bridge itself, died at the scene after he was struck by the locomotive, and two others were injured and airlifted to a local trauma center. The train engineer tried to stop the train and warn the people on the bridge before they were forced to jump from it. A sad ending to an ongoing legend.